Alright guys, welcome back to a Minecraft how-to video. This how-to video, I will be teaching you guys how to use Minecraft Forge and how to install Minecraft mods for Minecraft Forge. So, first you're going to need Minecraft Forge, and before I install Minecraft Forge, I'm going to go ahead and tell you what Minecraft Forge is. Minecraft Forge is the API that most mods for Minecraft use, and you can... it basically makes the installation of mods very simple, and most mods require it. So, without further ado, this is how you install Minecraft Forge. You go to files.minecraftforge.net. This link will be in the description below. You're going to find the version that you want. I'm going to go with 1.7.10 latest. You're going to click installer, and then you'll be redirected to an AdFly thing. If you're unfamiliar with AdFly, it's just basically a money collector thing. And you'll have to wait 5 seconds, and then you can click. Actually, I can probably show you. Yeah. So you see, you'll get a little bit of an ad. Whatever this is, it's either completely unhelpful or a virus. You don't want that. You're going to wait till up here till it counts down to zero. You're going to click skip ad, and then it'll download the file. I'm actually going to discard it because I already downloaded it, but you can click keep, but you'll want to click keep. So I've already got the file downloaded. We can close this tab now, and we can go back to downloads. I do have this all the way to the side to protect my identity. I have some personal files over there. So you'll go to the downloads here, and then you have your Forge installer. This is very simple installation. Double click it, and it'll pop this up. It'll install it for you. So we install client, and you're gonna have it set to your user, app data, roaming, Minecraft. It should find that by default. You click OK. It'll download a few files. Can take a little bit of time, but shouldn't take too long. I'll be back when it's finished. Finished. There we go. It's done. Okay. There we go. So, Minecraft Forge is already installed, ready to go. You can open up your launcher here. And you will notice, as soon as this thing loads, that you have a new profile. Now, it won't switch by default. You'll still have your Cosmic Cop. Or, no, you won't have a Cosmic Cop profile. You'll have your username profile. But there's a new profile right there. Click play, it'll be ready to update and play. It'll download a few miscellaneous files, and it'll launch, and it will get into the game at some point here, whenever it decides to load. Okay, so once you're in Minecraft Forge, you'll see down here there's some extra text. It says Minecraft Forge version and all that. We have 3 mods loaded, 3 mods active. You have this extra tab here called mods. We don't have any mods here. The 3 mods that listed are the Minecraft Coder Pack, Forge Mod Loader, and Minecraft Forge. So those are the only 3 things that are in here. There's no real mods per se so far, but that's where you go and see what mods you have installed. All right, so we can quit out of that for the moment. Now, to actually install a mod, pretty simple. All you gotta do is download a mod. I'll be using the Random Things mod, which is one of my favorite mods. So basically for this, just click download. After you're on the mod page, all mods are use different places to host, so all the downloads will be different for different mods. But this one is pretty simple, automatic download. Again, I've already downloaded this file, so it's pretty simple what you would do right there. Anyways, you have your file. It should be in your downloads folder. Now what you're going to do is go to your start bar. You're going to type in percentage app data percentage. Oops, percentage. Okay, and then you're going to click the roaming file. Now you're in your computer. So look at C users cosmic cop app data roaming. Except you will have whatever your username is. And basically the reason I had to go to the start bar to find this instead of going to here is that the app data file is a hidden file. Now you can adjust your computer settings and make it so you can always see that file, like I've done. However, most of you probably will not have done that already, and this is just a much easier, quick solution. So, that in your roaming file, you're gonna click .minecraft, and you will see that there's now a mods folder here. It's empty. So what you need to do is you're gonna alt tab back to your downloads file. You're going to control X or right click, cut the file. You come back, go to the mods file, put it right there. Simple as that. Exit out. And when your launcher loads, it's going to download a few files and launch. And when it loads, you'll see there's now 4 mods loaded, 4 mods active. When you come in here, you can see the random things mod is here. You can disable it, you can configure it, but it's already ready to go. Create a world, and you can start playing with your mod. So there you go. Minecraft Forge makes things so much simpler, and it makes it really easy to download and install whatever amount of mods you want. Now the best thing is, as long as there's no item ID conflicts. Oh, this is a good survival island seed. If you guys want the seed, there it is, Minecraft 1.7.10. So you can install whatever mods you want. They don't have to be by the same author or anything. You can just put them all together in the mods folder of Forge, and just start up Minecraft Forge and play your game. Now, sometimes there will actually be incompatibilities with certain mods, and you'll have to do some testing with that. I'm getting a weird frame rate lag here. But, like, if there's an item ID conflict, for example, that would mean 2 mods are incompatible forever unless you get the mod author to change the IDs. Or if you're skilled with coding, then you can go fix it yourself. Although, I'm guessing that if you're skilled with coding, you probably wouldn't be watching this video in the first place. Anyways, that's about it for Minecraft Forge. If you have any questions, post them in the comments below. I'll try my best to answer them. And like, comment, subscribe if I helped you here. And I will see you all next time. Bye.